good luck, Ep.
Oh, good. It seems you're both still here inside me, then.
It is not as though we desired these circumstances. We're only here because you ate us.
I'll make no apologies.
You wish to sacrifice us to the four elemental Empyreans, is that it?
Yes. I won't apologize for that, either.
It matters not. Your sins are nothing a mere apology could ever absolve.
I know.
At least you're aware of how selfish you are. Good for you, then.
Remember this well, Lord of Calamity. No matter how many times I am reborn, I will act the same.
As will I.
And I as well.
Did you say something?
Just dreaming is all. But I know now how deep my sins run.
Velvet, there's something I've wanted to talk to you about. It's about the Therians. And about Lafayette.
Let me guess. The link between us and You Know Me Not.
Yes. There's no way of knowing what will happen until we actually try, but...
You don't have to worry about me. I said it before. Best just to blame all the wickedness of the world on the Lord of Calamity.
Don't you try to shoulder all of this yourself! We exorcists are just as much at fault for letting things come to this. So let me ponder what to do about Kamoana and the rest, but you need to think about Lafayette. There, I've said my piece.
I don't know which of us is more stubborn. Still, I've got to face the truth. I've got to tell him.
Good. This place hasn't been suppressed yet.
We're unloading. Give me a hand, will ya?
Hey, you listening?
Sorry. Something just feels weird. Like there's something tugging at my thoughts.
Yeah, I've been hearing a lot of that lately. But pull yourself together. Yeesh!
Yet being the operative term here.
We'd better get a move on.
Benwick, don't leave Kamoana or Medissa's domain. Got it? The Therians are part of Innominat. They should be able to resist suppression to some extent.
Aye, aye. You watch yourself too, First Mate.
Mount Killerous is at the northern edge of Northgand. Bit of a trek.
It'd be nice if we could resupply along the way.
There's a town, Mercio, near the foot of the volcano. It faces the sea, but the currents lately have been too strong to approach it by water. However, the land route should still be clear.
The whole continent has been getting colder of late, not just Northgand.
Colder? Could it have something to do with Innominat? Or maybe it's because the elemental Empyreans are asleep.
Both sound possible. But think too hard about the cold, and it'll give you the shivers.
Yeah, but even so...
Whatever the case, our course remains the same. We'll head to Mercio and work from there.
My son came home from the capital and said he'd take over the family fishing business. That was always my dream. But is it really best for the world? For him to waste his talents on such a primitive activity?
Dad, what are you saying? I thought we talked about this.
You should use your education to help the country and people all across the world. That is the way of reason.
That guy is acting really oddly.
Wait, we talked about this?
Yeah, you agreed that I should use my knowledge to advance fishing technology and stabilize the world's food supply. Remember?
Oh. Yes, that's right.
Shape up, Dad. What's the problem? Drinking too much?
Just a nightcap before bed.
If you need some rest, I'll take the boat out myself today.
That'd be the day. Like I'd put you in charge. You're not ready to take the boat out by yourself.
An ill-fated fisherman's fortune. His memories are muddied. But is it divine will that dulls his wits, or drink?
A sailor who can't handle his drink is just as shameful as one who gets seasick.
Daddy, we're having a long-armed crab hot pot party when you come home tonight.
As the world gets colder, the long-armed crab's habitat expands.
Do your best out there today.
If the crabs breed too quickly, it will affect the fish.
Hey, that guy is...
Daddy? You're acting weird.
Oh, sorry about that. My mind just wandered away from me there for a second.
If you do that on your boat, you'll fall into the sea.
Yeah, that's right. I'll be careful.
Good luck out there!
That boy's father, he was acting strangely.
The suppression is starting to affect people out here, too.
Thank you. opened our arms and welcomed that vagabond into our town. But despite our kindness, he robbed us, started fights, caused trouble. Then he stole a boat and escaped. But I was the one that let him go. I'm guilty too. We have to be strict with criminals.
Rogues always seem to drift into Hellavise, don't they?
Huh? Were we talking about something?
Wait, did you forget what you just said?
Yeah, I hope I didn't say anything strange.
We were talking about how nice of a guy you were.
Huh?
Don't be so hard on yourself, okay?
Huh?
I see you're at it again.
Am I that predictable?
That stance. It's called nothingness, right? A clear state of mind and all that.
Does it look meditative or something? I wish it was, but really it's the exact opposite. It brings out all my negative thoughts. My hatred. My doubts. My ego. My anger. I take up my sword to cut myself free of such wrongful emotions. At least, that's what I used to think. But that's just not possible, is it? Not for anyone. Hell, even if I could let go of that part of myself, I'm not sure I'd want to.
Because if you let go of your desire to kill Shigure, you'd lose your purpose in life?
My spiteful thoughts, my wrongful feelings, my pride, my inner contradictions. All these are parts of who I am. Through practice, I learn to embrace who I am. The good and the bad, and become the swordsman only I can be. That's the only way I will achieve what cannot be done. Defeating Shigure.
And Shigure. He's already at peace with his inner self.
Exactly. And so are you.
You really think so?
I do. That's why I will never give up. Besides, I still need to repay my debt to you.
Well, I look forward to seeing the final results, that's for sure.
Sinner, and repent your wicked deeds.
Yes, Father. I am here.
No, I wasn't talking to you. Surely an exorcist has nothing to repent. Truly, the sinners are those people you're with who come into this cathedral and say whatever they please.
No, Father. I've done a great many things that I regret. For instance, I once put blind, unquestioning faith in the Abbey's ideals of reason and justice. In making any decision, I used not my head, or my gut, or my heart, but instead relied on the Abbey's answers.
Ah!
I lorded my authority over those I thought to be below me, when I didn't even know the truth of how things actually worked.
What?
I was telling other people how to live their lives when I needed to look at my own flaws instead. But I won't repent for my past deeds. To seek forgiveness from the Empyreans would be to repeat those very same mistakes. I will follow my own judgment now, as I strive to make amends for the misdeeds and regrets of my past.
Please, Lady Exorcist, listen to my confession, for I have much to repent.
Huh? Father, why are you crying?
Did you hear that Moloch they were doing experiments on finally broke?
Yeah. You mean the one where they were trying to combine multiple smaller Molochim into one giant Moloch? I always figured it was a waste of time.
Turns out it not only looked like a freak, but its shackled mind snapped, leaving the thing feral.
Huh? Guess they'll have to dispose of it.
Yeah. For now, they've moved it out to the Faldi's ruins. They're repurposing it as a test target for a new Moloch art and development.
At least we'll be able to get some valuable data out of it.
Using Molochim for their own ends. Is there no line they won't cross?
I hope you're not thinking of doing anything unnecessary.
Oh? Like what?
Like thinking about bringing mercy to a broken Moloch.
What I think is necessary and what actions I take are for me to decide.
Aizen!
That exorcist said they were using the Moloch to get data on a new Moloch art. If it were complete, they could use it against us. Stopping that wouldn't be a waste of our time, would it?
You think you know just what to say to me, don't you?
I'm just stating the truth.
Just so we're clear, we're not going to rescue it.
No argument here.
Freezing before. Now it goes straight to the bone.
Allow me to warm.
Not Nessa.
Oh? The sneezes are going around? Achoo! So cold. If it's this bad here, I dread to think of what the Guyberg ice field is like.
The tundra past Mount Killerhouse? Is it really that cold?
I've stayed up in the mountains many times for my training. With all the snow, I imagine it'd be pretty rough for a normal human.
Why are you sneezing all of a sudden? Demons aren't supposed to feel cold.
Nah, a snowflake just flew up my nose and...
Achoo!
You're sneezing too.
My hair was blowing around and tickled my nose.
But according to the old book I read, it isn't supposed to snow much around Guyberg.
Because of lava from the volcano and the Earth's natural heat. I bet the book calls it Guyberg Plains, too.
Yeah, it says Mount Killerhouse was highly active, and the area used to be famous for its hot springs.
But now it's... What?
Why are you all staring?
They're all expecting you to sneeze, I think.
Everyone else is doing it!
Now give us a good show!
Ah... Sorry, everyone. No sneezes here. I'll practice for next time.
Ah, good grief. This must be that experimental Moloch.
Why a cow's head? This is bull. Careful! It's on a rampage!
Time to put a stop to this!
Slow down!
See this?
Slow down!
Enormous bovine Moloch? Was that the best the Abbey could think up?
As if robbing our free will wasn't enough. Now they're trying to reshape Molochim.
I'm so sorry, Eisen. What they did here was terrible.
I don't really care about the callous experimentation. If the Molochim participated by their own free will, then sure, that's their choice. But this one had its free will locked away and was used and discarded like a mere tool. That's what I can never forgive. And the Abbey is treating countless Molochim the same way.
Sounds like this has gotten you all fired up. Maybe I'm glad we came here.
Oh, believe me. I've been fired up for a good long time. Ever since I decided how I want to live my life. I knew this would be big. Show.